Hi, everyone. My name is Krishna Dhanyamraju. I'm a fourth-year medical student at OU-HCOM, and I'm interested in applying to general surgery. So clinical rotations are basically like an internship for a job. You will go in for 4 to 8 weeks, sometimes more, sometimes less, and you're going to basically take on some of the duties of an attending or a resident in that specialty. And you're going to learn about some of the common conditions they deal with and the diagnostic and treatment modalities and see if you have an aptitude for it, if it's something you'd like to spend your career doing. So my first rotation was psychiatry. My main worries were things like, what do I have to submit to the school? Am I going to get my forms in on time? And I was really kind of worried, what do I do if the attending puts me on the spot with the patient? Am I going to flounder, or am I going to rise to the occasion?
Hi, my name is Cece Hanline. I am in my OPCA year currently, which means I took a break between my third and fourth year of medical school to teach clinical skills to the first and second year students here. Now that I've done my third year, I feel confident in introducing myself to a patient and listening to them, taking a good history, and knowing where to find my resources so that I can come up with a good plan for the patient. I am now pretty confident in knowing what I don't know and knowing what I do know, and differentiating those two things is pretty important when you're working in a hospital. I think on rotations, I was most concerned that I needed to know everything the first day. And what I've learned based on that concern is that you're expected to be a student at the hospital. You're expected to work hard, but you're expected to not know everything and ask questions and just be enthusiastic about what you're learning.
So clinical experiences are going to be highly individual. I would recommend that you stop and think about what it is you want out of your rotation specifically. It's more so, are you interested in an academic setting with residents and fellows and attendings, or would you prefer a more one-on-one approach with your attending where you're taking on more workload, but you also have a more intimate experience with that specialty?
I think what I liked most about my rotations was just how I was constantly learning, and I didn't feel like everything I did was like, oh, I have to memorize this fact for a test. Of course, there's tests at the end of rotations, but the learning felt a lot more active, and I felt like I engaged with it a lot more.
I mostly leaned on my friends who were rotating at my site with me. I was lucky to have a cohort that I was close with even before rotations began, as well as my APA and some of my attendings as well. In every specialty that you go to, whether you think you'll like it or not, try to go into it with an open mind. You might be surprised. And try to find something that you like, whether it's pathology or what the attending does or how they approach treatment, that you like and want to take away for your own practice one day.
I think that when you're choosing a clinical site, it can seem really intimidating because it seems like it can predict a lot about your future. What I would suggest considering is, like, first think about your learning style. Are you somebody who likes to do something after just reading about it or being told how to do it and then just giving it a try? Or are you someone who likes to watch someone else do something and then attempt it?
My name is Scott Rogers, and I'm the Associate Dean of Clinical Education here at the Heritage College. So medical school training involves several years of book learning and several years of more practical clinical application in the clinical learning environment. That includes rotational experiences in our hospitals and clinics all across the state in various specialties of interest. One of the biggest benefits for students entering the clinical learning environment is to have practical hands-on application caring for patients. It's a great opportunity to really practice that apprenticeship model where they see and do alongside other physicians and healthcare professionals caring for patients in a variety of settings. Students in Dublin rotate primarily in Central Ohio locations. Students in the Cleveland campus rotate primarily in the Cleveland sites. Students in Athens have a wide variety of options with 11 of our different cohort sites all across the state of Ohio. Students are primarily assigned to one clinical campus, and all rotations occur within about 60 miles or 60 minutes of that particular campus. There are some rare exceptions to that, but students are provided housing in those situations. If you choose to embark on a four-year journey here at Heritage College, rest assured that your clinical learning environment will bring you meaningful success so that you ultimately can serve a community as an osteopathic physician in a myriad of ways. We here at the Heritage College Department of Clinical Education are here to support you on that journey every single step of the way.